ask expert guitar players or vintage enthusiasts about their desert island amplifier. In many cases, the reply will be Fender Tweed Deluxe of the 1950s, with the latest version 5E3 getting more consensus in particular. In fact, these models are consistently ranked in the top 10 of the most legendary amplifiers. I have here two great vintage original pieces, with their distinctive tweed covering still in good shape, a 1953 5C3 version and a 1955 5E3 model. These two amplifiers will help us to find out what's the big deal with the Tweed Fender Deluxe. We all make mistakes. In the late 90s, I used to own a fabulous original vintage Fender Tweed Deluxe 5E3 amplifier from 1958. I absolutely loved its tone. Unfortunately, the speaker's cone had a tear, which got worse after a few gigs. At the time, there was no internet and no Jensen reissues. It was really difficult to find a proper vintage replacement speaker or recone kit in Italy. And the reissues then available sounded nothing like the originals. My main concern was having a trustworthy gigging amplifier, so I took the decision to let it go. The decision is even more regrettable considering that the value of that amp skyrocketed in the last few years. My dear friend Giacomo Bagorda lent me a couple of great vintage pieces that he just acquired. I'm now thrilled to go for a ride with a vintage Tweed Deluxe after 25 years. And I won't hide that receiving and opening the parcel from the seller Luigi caused me some heartbeat palpitations. Let's try to find out what's so special in the vintage Tweed Deluxe amplifiers. In mid-1946, the Fender Electric Instrument Company amp line consisted of three models: the large Professional, the small Princeton, and the mid-sized Model 26 with 10-inch speaker. The cabinet of these amplifiers had stained hardwood finish with no cover, leading to the nickname of Woody Models. In summer 1948, the Woody Models evolved into a new series, covered with airplane luggage lining, with even texture. The cabinet was now made in solid pine wood with strong finger corner joints. The design of this new line was clearly inspired by the TV sets of those years, which earned them the nickname of TV front models. The Woody Model 26 was replaced by the tweed-covered 5A3, which established the Deluxe model to its definitive 1x12 speaker cabinet configuration. In the 5A3 code name, the first number indicates the decade, 1950s in our case, even if it was launched in the late 1940s. The letter in the middle designates the version of the circuit, and the final number indicates the model, 1 for the Little Champ, 2 for the Princeton, 3 for the Deluxe, and so on. By 1949, the TV front amps finally received the iconic lacquered tweed cover with diagonal lines. In 1950, Fender introduced a new version of the Deluxe, labeled 5B3, with only minor circuit modifications. In late 1952, the cabinet design of the 5B3 and other models underwent a noticeable restyling. This new generation of tweed amps, with squared-off grey cloth corners, is commonly known as wide panel. In summer 1953, we arrived to the 5C3 wide panel Deluxe, which we have here. This model still preserves the original firecracker red Astron capacitors. This is likely one of the earliest models carrying a date code on the tube chart. It's stamped right by the edge and it went partially lost, but fortunately it was also stamped inside the chassis. CH points to August 1953. It could have left the Fullerton plans together with my beloved Telecaster The Witness. Like its predecessors, the 5C3 control panel presents a single tone control and two volume controls, one for the microphone input and the other for the two instrument inputs. The 5C3 was also given an independent power switch, while in the previous versions it was activated with the tone knob. The main difference in the circuit design of the 5C3 is the addition of a negative feedback loop, making it sound a bit more clean with a more balanced bass frequencies response. It puts out about 14 watts through its glorious Jensen P12R Concert Series Alnico speaker. The 5C3 also has the addition of an external speaker jack under the chassis. I'd like to say a few words about the audio recording. In the BTR channel, we debate about subtle differences that required a trained ear to be detected, even when listening live. That's why recording high-quality vintage gear in a satisfactory way means capturing the nuances of their tone. From this perspective, the choice of microphones cannot be casual. Braingasm Lab Custom Microphones, based in Rome, has accepted this challenge and came to our help. I'm using the Ferro model, which is a JFET large diaphragm condenser microphone with an output transformer. The Braingasm Ferro is sided by a simple Audix i5 dynamic microphone. I will try to explain this choice in detail in one of the next episodes. I'm scheduled to a studio recording session next week. I will try to convince my producer to collaborate on an episode dedicated to the interesting subject of guitar cab miking and recording. Back to the Tweed Deluxe. In 1954 saw the debut of the short-lived 5D3 Deluxe variant, still with wide panel cosmetics. The negative feedback loop circuit of the 5C3 was ultimately removed. While the previous models mounted old-style octal metal tubes in the preamp section, the 5D3 adopted the new smaller glass tubes with novel sockets. Early 5D3 amplifiers were still labeled with outdated 5C3 internal tube charts. The references to the old tubes were manually corrected until official 5D3 tube charts were printed. In 1955, the Tweed amplifier line underwent another major restyling. The new deluxe version, obviously labeled 5E3, came in a bigger cabinet with narrower front panels, therefore nicknamed Narrow Panel Model. The grill cloth was changed to the familiar woven texture type. The 5E3 remained in production until 1960 and represents the most popular version of the Tweed Deluxe. This piece is from the first production year. After 1957, the logo plate will also show the Deluxe model designation name. The 5E3 panel also featured a ground switch. The 5E3 circuit outputs about 15 watts. It offers more preamp gain and less power tube saturation than the other models. This means more clean headroom and more aggressive preamp distortion at higher volume. In essence, the 5E3 is credited to have a little extra dose of both clarity and kick. The Tweed covering used in the 1950s suffered the harsh treatment of the road. It was subject to fray, tear and stain. For this reason, the Tweed era came to an end. Fender switched to the durable vinyl Tolex covering for the amplifiers of the following decade. To revive the 5E3 legend, Fender in 2016 introduced the 1957 Custom Tweed Deluxe reissue and the Edge signature version with hand-wired board and a Celestion Blue speaker for a British touch. The 5Y3 tube rectifier and the pair of 6V6 power tubes remained constant throughout each version of the Tweed Deluxe. The characteristic sag of the 5Y3 contributes to the great compression and overdrive and to the typical mushy bass response of these amplifiers. Another constant of the Tweed era deluxe amps is the basic single tone knob with individual volume controls for the two channels. The volume control of the inactive channel and the tone knob affect the active channel's gain, which is a unique feature that accounts to the versatility of these amps. To take full advantage of this feature, Neil Young, who is probably the most relevant Tweed Deluxe addicted artist, in 1978 created, with his tech Sol Trentino, a custom device named the Wizzer. It's a robotized remote control, turning the knobs to 4 preset settings. This way, Young could get progressive degrees of distortion without using any gain pedals. In fact, the Tweed Deluxe amps can go from awesome compressed clean tone to warm creamy overdrive and even to gritty and punchy distortion while always keeping a unique response to finger touch. We'll be right back. To fully understand the sonic character of the Tweed Deluxe models, we have to go back to the days when these early Fender amps were conceived and comprehend the design philosophy behind them. Leo Fender and other manufacturers of the time had to face the challenge of producing amplifiers that kept sounding clean at loud volume levels. This means that they aimed for headroom as opposed to early breakup or saturation. In fact, distorted tone was still strictly considered an undesirable side effect. The upmarket models, considered professional-grade amps, sounded more clean at high volume. The Deluxe saturated at lower levels, it had an early distortion threshold and therefore ranked as a student amplifier. On the other hand, the characteristic warm saturation of the Tweed Deluxe models has a great appeal to contemporary guitarists. In spite of controls going up to 12, these Tweed Deluxe amps can give warm, juicy saturation at volume-friendly levels. They have relatively low output, making them ideal for gigging in small clubs, practicing and recording. In fact, they can be heard in countless records. Also, you can play them even at home at family-approved or neighbor-friendly volume levels. All these features make the Tweed Deluxe from the 50s greatly desirable and valuable, regardless of circuit varieties. All Deluxe amps are tone machines cleverly suited for many musical styles by virtue of their fat and harmonically rich overdrive. In particular, the sound of these amplifiers gave rise to a new form of music, named rock and roll. Of course, they are also a staple for classic raw blues tone, with both guitar and harmonica, as cleverly demonstrated by my dear friend and bandmate, Maestro Mino Leonetti. This is the sound that countless boutique makers strive to recreate. In fact, the Tweed Deluxe and 5E3 in particular is probably the most cloned amp of all time. Does this mean that the tone of the 50s Deluxe is perfect? Many experts and technicians actually agree that there's still room for improvement. In fact, these original Deluxe amps may sound a bit canned or boxed when compared to their bigger brothers. For example, the Tweed Deluxe would not be my amps of choice for twangy tones. Their tone can turn mushy, especially with hotter pickups or gain pedals. Also, they may benefit from a more pronounced and defined low end. To improve these aspects, some reversible modifications have been experimented. Some people try swapping the rectifier tube and the old metal preamp tubes of the earlier versions. Someone even pushes farther, putting 6L6 power tubes, but I would not do that. Finally, you can experiment with speakers. The P12Q is generally favored for its fatter tone over the P12R. I even tend to prefer the bigger Jensen P12N, original to the Twin, for more clarity and volume than the stock speakers. Someone mounts the ceramic version C12N, which is not period correct in a 50s amp, but still can be a good solution, as far as you like its sound. Bottom line, all in all, the hype is justified. The Tweed Deluxe is an iconic amplifier for good reason. Glorious organic tube tone to die for, and addictive playability, with the right ratio of that unmistakable raw natural overdrive and warm clean tone. But the vintage market is generous with hidden gems, and we'll see some in the next episodes. So don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to keep in touch. Feel free to join the Facebook group Bob Stone Review and visit our Instagram profile. Any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments below. Remember that your feedback and comments are the only fuel to keep the BTR channel going.